Hey, Matt 31, I had a question coming out of section 6.7, number 41, and here we were told about a pot of boiling soup with an initial temperature of 100 degrees Fahrenheit, and it was taken off the stove to cool in a room that was 69 degrees Fahrenheit, and then it's saying after 15 minutes, the temperature of the soup was 95 degrees, so did the nearest minute, how long did it take the temperature, or to take the soup to cool to 80 degrees. So let's take a look at what we have. I can see that I have my initial temperature of 69 degrees and that the surrounding temperature is, I think I said that backwards. Initial temperature of 100 degrees and surrounding temperature of 69 degrees. And then I have this ordered pair. It says 15 minutes later, the soup was down to 95 degrees. So how long is it going to take to cool to 80? So it's definitely going to take longer than 15 minutes because at 15 minutes, it's only at 95 degrees. So I don't know, just eyeballing it, I would say if it took 15 minutes just to lose 5 degrees temperature, right, because it's going from 100 to 95, that maybe it's going to take like another like 30, 40 minutes to get all the way down to 80. If we left the soup out forever, it would eventually cool down to 69 degrees, but we're not going to do that. All right, so this is going to follow Newton's law of cooling. So here's my model, my exponential model. So T sub S, it's the surrounding temperature, right? So in this case, that's going to be 69. And A is the difference between the temperature of the soup and its surrounding temperature. So the temperature of the soup was 100 degrees, and the surrounding temperature was 69 degrees. So my A value is going to be 31. So there I am plugging in my A value and my T sub S to my Newton's law of cooling. And I always want to get this K value, right? That's what I want to do. So I need an ordered pair to make that happen. And luckily I have one, right? We had 15 and 95. So let me change pen colors here. This is going to be an ordered pair for little t and then capital T. So I'm quite literally going to plug in 95 here, but for little t, oops, let me get rid of that. Oh, I love when this happens. Let me get my eraser popping up for just a bit. All right, here we go. I'm going to plug in 95 for big T. I'm going to plug in 15 for little t, and I'm going to solve for K. All right, and that's what you see me doing throughout all of this next stuff, right? So I plug in my numbers, and like always, I want to isolate the exponential term. All right, because my variable, the one I want to solve for, K, is up in an exponent, I need to get that exponential term all by itself. And right now it's got a plus 69 with it and a multiply by 31. So I need to undo that. So I'm going to subtract 69 from both sides. Then I'm going to divide by 31 and that gets me here. And then because my variable is up in an exponent, I'm going to log both sides. And I'm going to opt to use the natural log because we know that, natural logs and e's, those are inverse operations of one another. And those are going to cancel and leave me with just the 15k. So that's why you see me having 15k equaling the natural log of that ratio 26 over 31. Then what I need to do is divide both sides. Let me erase this out. Divide both sides by 15, and I get my k value. All right, so there is my model for Newton's law of cooling. And that seems like plenty right there. But we're still not done with the problem, because if we go back, it actually said, hey, how long does it take for this soup to get to 80 degrees? So if it's saying how long, I need to know the little t value, and they're giving me big T was 80. So what I'm about to do is I'm going to plug the 80 in here, and then I'm going to solve for little t. So if I scroll down, you're going to see my work on that, and it's the same setup as before, right? I want to isolate the exponential term. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to subtract the 69 again. I'm going to divide by 31 again. So a lot of the same mechanics happening, right? You see me logging both sides here. The ln and the e cancel out, so the exponent survives. I'm dividing by that exponent, and sure enough, I get down to 88.358, and it told me to round to the nearest minute, so there I am. It takes about 88 minutes for that soup to cool to 80 degrees. So you can leave it out for an hour, and or a little over an hour, but actually that's closer to an hour and a half, and it's down at 80 degrees. All right, thanks so much, everyone. Bye.